Y'all, I'll pray for you. I'll try to sleep. I'm going to kind of hard to sleep. Not play to sleep time.
Bless his heart. Oh. He's beautiful.
I look upon beneath the blue angel toward the ground.
It's all the sound. No, we don't. Even not this.
Who would we be tonight if we didn't look up and realize from where our call I'm the only one that's never bowed their head down. Up the veil of the Lord. I'll remember and let him know.
The Spirit of the Lord goes up here. Yeah.
The Spirit of the Lord is what helped you slay. He remembered what was going on.
Oh, yeah.
The Spirit of the Lord rose up and he slew the bear.
Come on. Come on.
Friends, sometimes it doesn't matter what we've done, we need to realize who makes it possible.
That's right.
And just because you hurt tonight,
come on, brother.
Doesn't mean you're any less Christian than who you are. Get that out of your head tonight.
Come on.
Get that out of your head tonight. You've not been saved with the spirit of fear. Not with the spirit of doubt. Not with the spirit of confusion, but the spirit of overcoming tonight.
Amen.
That's what we've been saved by.
Come on.
Overcoming through Christ Jesus. No other way. No other way.
Come on, bro.
There's so many times we forget where it starts. Start where you need.
That's
you know where it's going to end at? On my knees. I believe on that day I'm going to get down. I'm going to get down just like the
Lord. Amen.
Oh, glory, God. And I'm just going to whip around when he got out of the name of the sound word of the blood. God, I'm going to bow on point and reverence him for who he is. Right? He started on my knees and he ended on my knees. And along the journey, a long testing to the Lord for the pride and the high calling, along that way, I'm going to be on my knees searching for the Lord.
Yeah,
Paul was a great man. Maybe you know what? Maybe God does some great things in your life.
Yeah, man. Come on.
Don't exalt yourself. Mm-hmm. You know better than anybody else. Maybe God should give cancer. I don't know what I mean.
Amen.
Come on. But you don't exalt yourself above anybody else. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, come on.
It starts on our knees. And along the way, God will keep bringing if we let them. Mm-hmm. You know, we can have a slippery spirit.
Come on.
And not let the Lord bring us down to where we need to be. But tonight you know what it starts on our knees. And along the way we cry and we hurt. How many know tonight that God is still good?
Yeah. Amen.
Come on. No matter what you go through.
Anybody can give up.
I got a piece of this stuff. Paul
come
said,
on. Oh, thank you, Lord. Come on.
Paul said a message from Satan to buffet me lest I be exalted.
Yeah.
Come on. What did he go on to say there, Brother Tate? He said, I saw the Lord Christ. Three times I prayed for the Lord over the sheep. She was exactly what he said. Three times I prayed to God. Three times I went to you. Three times I asked you. And the last time he asked.
Come on.
What did he say? We all know the story.
Come on.
He said, Paul, my grace is sufficient.
Amen.
For all the way back.
Come on.
But Paul realized who he was.
I love
preaching on Paul.
Come on.
You know what? Because Paul's not like so many others. It's the same way.
Come on.
Friend, and I, God loves you.
Yeah.
It's all right when you hurt and cry, but don't forget how to get back in touch with the Lord.
Amen.
I feel like somebody needs it. I'm going to tell this testimony. I'm going to hush. I told it a couple Sundays ago, but I feel like tonight somebody in this church needs to hear this. My father told me one time he'd been saved. He was a young teenage boy, and you know what? He was struggling. I knew he was.
Come on, brother.
But sometimes it's so hard to talk to our children.
Yeah, come on.
And thank God, a man, God sent a man named Jimmy McCarty. Some of you may know him.
Yeah, come on.
God sent a man, God sent that man, and he said, come to me, and he said, Paul, there's something wrong with your son. I said, how'd you know? He said, I can feel it in my spirit.
Come on.
There's something wrong with you, boy. I said, Jimmy, I can't talk to you.
Come on.
I got to hear you. Some of you might have heard this out, some of mine. I said, Jimmy, I can't talk to you, but you don't want nothing. Please, you know better than if you were there to talk to my son.
Come on.
And after that day, he talked to my son, come to me. He said, Dad, I don't know how to get out of the family. Boy, I can tell you how to get out of the family. I live there. Come on. I got an address there. Come on.
Come on.
I got a mailbox in the mountain.
Come on.
I said, son, I can tell you how to get out of the mountain. You might have heard this a couple of times. I said, get down on your knees.
Yeah.
And as you pray, you begin to grab every little root and every little rock that you can get your hand in. And you begin to pull yourself up. And when you get to the top of the mountain, you can look up and give God the glory. For along the way, he made it possible.
Come on now.
Sometimes we need to be brought there. I preached a sermon. I was up now, bro.
Come on.
Come on. I preached a sermon a few years ago.
about being in the valley. Some of you may remember about being in the valley. It's not a bad place. But it's a place where you draw strength. So many Christians today think, well, you know what? I'll not go to the altar and pray. I'm too good for that. I'll just bow my head here at this church.
Come on, brother.
Friend, let me tell you what. Some of them need their legs cut out from underneath them so that my God will make them get on their knees.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah. He came once.
Come on.
With a reed in his hand.
Yeah, come on.
Ask him.
Yeah.
Ask him.
Yeah, come on.
He came once, asking him with a reed in his hand.
Come on.
The Bible says in the last day, the book of Revelation says, when you come back, you come back with a God of
honor. Yeah, come on.
Right. You know what he says he's going to do then? He's going to make my living good.
Come on.
What he wants us to do.
That's right.
He's going to make the high and the lofty.
Yeah,
bow the law. He's going to bring the nation. But you know what? I don't think he's going to have to make the same vow. You know why?
Come on.
Why? Because we read the true Lord tonight. As being our Savior.
We reverence you, Lord, tonight
as being our Redeemer. We reverence you, Lord, tonight for being our glory and everything that we are.
Yeah,
it's to invite you. We reverence you in the hell. Do we reverence you? We down on our knees, calling upon the name of the Lord.
Yeah, come on, come on. Yeah.
Sometimes we need to cry.
Yeah, come on.
And I like that song. I like that song. Why? Because you know what? Been a lot of times that I've cried. You know what? A lot of times, every time that I pray,
come on,
I never doubted who God was.
Come on,
and I always remembered how to get back in touch with Him. We're down on my knees.
Nehemiah.
Sometimes we don't spend enough time down on our knees.
Come on.
Sometimes we need to be crying out to the Lord like, woe me, Lord. Woe me, Lord. Give me an answer. You know what? Don't shut up till God gives you an answer. Woe is me, Lord. God's still God, friend. He'll never change. He's still God. He said, Elijah, wake up. He's telling the world today to wake up. You know what? There's a lot of people tonight that have not conformed to the world, but they've got to go down on their knees and call upon the same name of the Lord.
Amen.
A long way. I got to say this to the show, but along the way, brother, you're all hurt. Sometimes you're going to cry. But you just hang in or you get back down on your knees. Some people say grown men shouldn't cry. Let me tell you what, my wife and my children see me cry, but in my life that I've just saved.
Come on.
Because of things that I needed and because of things that I have done wrong and I realized and I was free. And I went to the Lord. And He's always made that way.
Amen.
I'm all
right. But if I'll get down on my knees, I'll look up to Him.
Yeah, come on.
Then let me tell you what, He can change everything in your life.
Yeah. Come on.
You know what happened to the praying along the way? I was just praying for the march of the crowd as I was talking to Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Press on that way. Press on that way. We got to keep pressing. We got to, I believe Brother Kenny Preaches a sermon here a couple weeks ago. Contend in the faith. We got to contend in the faith.
And I'm on
the faith. Faith that what? That what? You've been set free.
Amen. I'm on
the blood of Jesus Christ. And we're free. My friend, along this way, we're going to get ready. I tell you what, we're going to get ready to go to watery grave. I'm preaching nothing.
Come on.
But I feel like somebody needs to hear this. Now, you know what? It's okay to cry.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's okay to cry. You know why? Because it brings us back down just like Paul. Something bothering you enough to make you cry, let me tell you what, you're going to try to get rid of it out of your life, right?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Come on.
Come on.
What does God say in all things? Oh, He said the same thing to you. He said to Paul, my grace is sufficient. Look up. He told David, look up.
Yeah.
From which your strength comes from, look up.
Yeah.
Once we bow down, then we can look up. Sometimes, you know what, it's okay to cry. I'm going to ask you to get a song. I'm going to ask somebody to stand to this beat. We're going to be ready to go down to watery grave. Friend, I want you to know tonight, I believe in a people that is strong in the Lord. But I believe that, you know what? I believe that you're the same way as I am, Brother Tim.
I'm just a calm little fellowship to be, and this is one of those along the way that sometimes I've got to get around a brother that's stronger than me. I've got to draw some strength, and I've got to get down on my knees and realize where I'm at, and I got to get back to the basics of serving the Lord. I got to get back.